Right. Well, we have the Ortiga Center, which is, let's admit it, a lot of the revenue of Pasig comes from the Ortigas business district. I think we need to revitalize, tulungan natin ulit yung Ortigas Center. Ngayon medyo naka-catch up or na-overtake na tayo ng mga ibang business centers even from other cities.
So what would you do to ano?
Well, two things. First thing is corruption. As long as mabawasan yung under the table, I think business people will come in. Second, the one that Vico always mentions, participative government. You have to ask them what they need. If you do that and then you provide that, I think business people, entrepreneurs will come in Pasig.
Oh, I'm curious, taxes in Pasig City in terms of real estate, I mean, other taxes that would involve business, would you review that?
When I talk to business people in Pasig, especially the big ones, they're actually, they rarely complain about the tax rates. They compare about the unnecessary under-the-table deals. So if we clean up the government, we maintain the taxes, tataas pa nga yung revenue kasi mababawasan yung under the table, mapupunta lahat sa legit. I think that would be enough for now. But of course, we'll review everything. But my initial inclination would be to keep the tax rates as they are. Definitely, hindi muna natin tataasan. Hindi talaga natin tataasan. But if we reduce the corruption, it will really benefit the business.
Okay, what about the flooding problem in Pasig? Is it severe by the flooding problem? Because you told me there were two phases of Pasig. Mm-hmm. You have the Ortigas Pasig and the Pasig that's very poor.
Ondoy, right?
Yes,
Ondoy. In fairness to the current administration, the flooding has really improved in the last, especially after Ondoy. I think that was really a big wake-up call.
Yeah.
Now, there are still pockets in Pasig na binabaha pa rin. So, yun na lang yung kailangan i-focus. But yung big, I guess, Congressman would...
Karen, I think the most important thing is to remove politics from from this thing about the basic services like preventing flooding. Kakampi man o kalaban, yung lugar na yon dapat ayusin natin yung drainage system, ayusin natin yung flood control doon para siguraduhin natin na pagka, if another Ondoy, but hopefully that doesn't happen again, happens, I at least we will be able to immediately mitigate the flooding. Because at one point, you know, if it will be like Ondoy, flooding will happen because of the because it's not only Pasig that that's involved. It's the whole Metro Manila, probably the whole country.
I'm curious, kasi in-city housing is also a priority, no?
Yes.
Ilan ba ang urban poor in Pasig?
Right now, the problem is that statistics aren't clear. If you look at the national statistics, it would peg the rate at around 3% or even less. But if you go around Pasig, you know it's not just 3% who are poor. In fact, I talked to some of the staff of Mayor Joy Belmonte. That was one of the first things that she did even before she became mayor, was to conduct a poverty assessment of Quezon City. So we'll copy
that.
What she did.
We
need to find out yung exact rates, or at least yung medyo accurate naman. Because we can't make a plan if we don't know what's happening, or we don't have the exact numbers.
Okay, I'm curious, in city housing, do you mean by that you have land to actually build homes?
I think there's still going around. Number one, we have to release the land inventory of Pasig. We have to make that public.
Isko said, parang bliss, simple. Sabi niya, alam niyo yung bliss, yun ang gusto kong gawin.
The thing is, in Pasig, we actually have a lot of housing projects. The problem is, yung palakasan, the people who were actually living there before the housing projects were built, hirap na hirap silang kumuha ng housing units. But those na medyo malakas, nakakuha 2, 3, 4 housing units, which is obviously wrong.
Yeah.
And that's a form of corruption. So if we remove the palakasan system, I think there will be enough.
You have beneficiaries that have nanandun?
More than two, yes.
That's terrible.
It is terrible.
What would you do with that? How would you make that correction?
We need to clean up the system, kung paano yung tagging and identification of kung sino yung makakuha.
Did you want to add, Roman?
Yep, exactly. Not only the land inventory, but the inventory of those beneficiaries already.
Right.
Okay, education. Okay, education. That was also part of your big five agenda.
Yes.
Yeah. What would you change when it comes to education in Pasig?
When it comes to education,
how many schools are there that's government and not private?
The public schools. I think Kong Romano Commission on Higher Education, Committee on Higher Education.
More or less, we have 41 public schools in Pasig alone.
Yes, 30 barangays.
30 barangays.
Okay, go on.
First of all, I think we have to start implementing the laws that we made in the previous Congress. We had a lot of laws like giving opportunities to go to college if you're a top 10, the scholar ng bayan law.
Yes.
If you're a top 10 graduate of any public high school, you're automatically admitted to any state university or college. Second, in fact, I was the one who wrote the free college education during my time, except that they amended it a bit. And I think we have
to oversight. But then you can claim it. You've never claimed that.
I think we have to have an oversight on the amendment done. Because actually many of the beneficiaries there were not the target beneficiaries. Because if you read the law that I wrote, it's not only free college education. But together with that, we should help them out with an allowance. Because sometimes that is heavier on the family than the tuition fee itself. But right now, since they amended it and made it as simple, anyone in a state university is already automatically, no matter what the income you have, is automatically a free tuition fee. I think we should take a look now and see if that is effective, if it helped out the target beneficiaries.
But I'm curious because, you also authored an act providing scholarship grants to top graduates of public schools. That's what you said.
Yes.
And have there already been students who have taken advantage of this?
Yes, during my last year in Congress, the UP system was telling me that they had a lot of applicants. But sadly, in these last 3 years, I've not heard really a promotion by the Department of Education, who is that's the department who's supposed to inform our students
that
there is such a law. But I guess the Department of Education has been busy with many other things. But they have to focus on giving people that opportunity to go to college.
So I'm quite curious, in the local spectrum, how would you improve these 30 public schools, 41 public
schools? First of all, what we have to do is improve the quality of education.
Yeah.
In the Philippines, we have a lot of organizations here who help out local governments in terms of improving reading, writing, and quality education.
Yeah.
And they do it not just to say that they're doing it, but actually they measure their improvements.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I think we have to seek the assistance of these groups in order to improve the quality of education.
Okay. And then you did talk about public consultation, which we started on the show, because you'll have civil society included, and anti-corruption efforts, which you had discussed also.
Right.
In your first 100 days, or what's the right measurement? Do you want to do 1 year? What is the top priority of Vico Sotto? Wherein visually people can see it, there's a change. Ay, ito na bago niya. I think for all mayors, that's such a challenge that there's a change that you can actually see.
Right,
what is the first thing you do?
Well, since number one, healthcare, that's what I've been talking about, the whole campaign. Of course, aside from making sure that the human resources of the city are intact, making sure that we have good people in there, good people with integrity. When it comes to healthcare, yung gamot uunahin natin.
We'll
make sure that they're actually available in the hospitals and health centers.
Okay.
It will be very difficult. Baka saktong-sakto lang tayo sa 100 days, but we'll do everything we can to make sure that this happens.
Okay. We just have 5 minutes left. Very quickly, Roman. Now that you're going back to Congress, does this mean everything President Duterte wants passed is a yes to you?
Again, Karen, as I mentioned earlier, let's move on. Let's move forward from this being red or yellow. I think let's be mature enough to help him out with programs that I think will really help the Philippines. But of course, if they if they're not in jive with my principles, then of course not.
Okay. So would you have voted for, or let's say it's brought up again, lowering the age of criminal liability?
That particular thing, I think we have to study that just to make sure, just to ensure that the reason why they want to lower it, because to lower it just like that without the support system, I think would be detrimental to our country.
Okay, quickly, what about the traffic problem?
Right.
Is that a priority too?
Yes, definitely. It was in the Big Five agenda, because the Big Five agenda
is
from the consultative.
Traffic.
Definitely traffic. We start with the little things. Like for example, dapat walang quota ang mga traffic enforcer na manghuli na manghuli para yung focus nila ay sa daloy ng traffic. Uh-huh. Thinking long term, we need to come up with a traffic management plan. Actually, not a traffic management plan, a mobility management plan.
Yun.
We're not trying to move cars here. We're trying to move people and make sure they get to their destinations as quickly as possible. So we need to shift the focus a little bit. Of course, cars will still be included in that.
Yeah.
But ultimately, this plan needs to be data-driven.
Okay. Yeah. Now, to close the show, I mean, you are a born-again Christian. Mm-hmm. When you won, your mom, of course, the famous Connie Reyes, raised your hand and said, "To God be the glory."
Right.
I think, "To God be the glory, praise Jesus," or "Thank you, Jesus." And it was quite touching. Huh? I can relate to that moment in time where a mother would feel that. Your being a born-again Christian, will it define your leadership? Where does Jesus play a role in all this?
Right. I think it's really important for us to have leaders with the fear and love of God. It doesn't mean that, you know, the policy making will be, you know, based on, you know, it's just
indeed,
important,
you know.
Integrity. I think my grounding and, you know, the fact that I grew up in church with people who are watching me and making sure that
So
I think that's very important.
Nakikinig ka nga daw, sabi ni Connie sa simbahan, di niya, akala niya hindi ka nakikinig. Nakikinig ka pala daw. And then when asked about your having a girlfriend, which I did here, you're 29, but you said something funny. You said, "Bahala na si Lord dyan, matutulog na lang ako." Okay, it's clearly not a priority?
Right now, it's not a priority. I'm not going out of my way because sabihin to find a girlfriend or anything. That's just there are too many things that need to be done right now.
I was gonna say, sa dami na sakit ng ulong sasalubugin mo. I
mean, baka madagdagan pa.
Okay, wait, how does Vic Sotto feel? I mean, your dad was also interviewed. He said, "I can't believe my anak na akong mayor."
I know he's very proud of me.
He
is. And he always tells me that he's very proud of me. But I think also he's very relieved that the campaign period is over.
It's over.
Yes, he helped us a lot. But he was, syempre, magulang. Both my parents, my entire family was very nervous. You know, but after the proclamation, parang... very relieved.
Okay. Now, Roman, is you and Shalani, you've been married 8 years already, and are you still trying for kids?
Yes. In fact, I think many have advised me right after the campaign to, you know, give some time to this thing.
Yeah. Hopefully. Wala ka bang time to have kids?
During the campaign?
During the campaign.
Well, I think we will make sure and ensure that we have a family.
Ah, that's nice. Okay. All right. And Shalani was saying that she's still, an interview conducted said that after all these years of marriage, is she still feels na ano, romantic towards you. She calls you, she has a term for you, a term of endearment. Oh, I can't remember.
That's between the...
Okay. All right. Well, thank you very much, Roman.
Thank you, Karen.
Thank you so much. Vico, is
thank
there anything
much.
Else you want to add? Thank you.
Well, if there are Pasigueños watching, I hope that, you know, now is the time to move forward. Supporter ko man o hindi supporter, ngayon panahon na po na narinig na natin ang tinig ng taong bayan. It's time for us to move forward. Let's be one. Magkaisa po tayo para sa ikabubuti ng ating lungsod. Maraming salamat po.